I'm going to go over one of the number one things you can do when it comes to losing belly fat, losing oblique fat, losing back fat, and being able to spot lose it, meaning like you could pin it down. And that's what it's going to be about today. I'm Jim Jones. I'm 51 years old, and I am a nutrition coach. And you've probably seen some of my videos, but if you haven't, please hit that like button and subscribe today, because you're going to learn. This is a doozy. And it all comes from a video that I seen where someone said, I should be fired for telling someone to focus on calories. And I about lost my mind. So today I'm going to lose my mind a little bit. I'm going to be a little bit forceful. I'm going to be like that person that you don't want to see on The Biggest Loser or something. Not that I'm advocating that, but listen. Because I'm going on a weight loss diet myself. I want to lose 5 pounds of body fat, but gain like 7 pounds of muscle. So bear with me on this and listen and stay to the end, because I'm going to show you that one specific thing that you stack on what you're about to learn on this whiteboard. So you got all kinds of nutrition people out there, you know, influencers out there. I listen to about 3 of them. That's it. 3. There's 3 people that I would sit down with right now and probably have this same conversation with. And I know for a fact that I'm going to be not 100% correct, but I'm going to be pretty damn close, because I've lived out there in this real world and have trained enough people and seen enough people lose 5 pounds. I've seen people lose 50 pounds. I've seen people lose 150 pounds or plus by following what I am about to show you. Simplicity, not overcomplicating the calorie by becoming... following these 2 processes, by becoming more aware and by learning. When you become aware, and that equals this, the caloric deficit and macros. Focus on this formula. Write that down, because this is going to come back to you. You're going to focus on this 99% of the time. Before you walk in a gym, before you start taking steps, before you watch even another video on how to lose belly fat, write that down. And we're gonna break this down right now. Very simple, very focused, right? Because if you wanna lose weight, lose body fat, and spot it, meaning get that belly fat off over time, you can do it. Don't let anybody say you can't. It takes time to get there, and it takes some combination of all of this, along with exercise. And I'm not talking about doing 1,000 crunches either. I'm sorry that was so loud, but I'm not re-recording this because I'm pumped right now. Listen, let's assume you want to weigh, I'm going to use my 200-pound person, man or woman, doesn't matter. Say you weigh 200 pounds. You want to get down to 180 to start. You want to lose 20 pounds, right? That's what I feel like the average person wants to lose. So you want to lose 20 pounds. It's not going to be 20 pounds of body fat, but it's going to be 20 pounds. Right? Listen, goal 180, you're going to take and multiply your goal weight, whether it's 180, 170, 160, you're going to multiply it times 10 to 12. Using the 180 number, this is what the calories look like. 1800 for 10, 1980 for 11, 2160 for 12. That is how many calories you are going to start at for the day. Every day. We're going to go in weeks, 1 week at a time, because you should be losing, let's say, 1% of your body weight every week. That's a good, healthy goal. But in the beginning, it could be more than that. And then it goes down. You know what I'm talking about, if you've ever been on that cycle, or where, okay, you gain it all back because the third week you don't see any improvements. Like January 1st. And you get to January 21st after you made all these resolutions, and all of a sudden you stop losing weight and the gym membership gets revoked. You revoke it, right? Because it's not working. This is why. So listen. So you're going to take this first week, 2,100 calories, and break them down into protein, fats, carbs. And we're going to learn how to do that. Right? That's what you're going to focus on, is learning what this is, but sticking to 1 gram per pound. Don't go to 0.8. That's what the average person is. You're not going to be the average person. You're going to be the above average person or the blowout person where you're going to focus on getting 1 gram or more per day in your body over carbs first, okay? So that's 180 to 200 grams of carbs. You're going to get 40 to 60 grams of fat. Stick on the lower side for week one, right? This is not week one, by the way. That is week one. I'm sorry. You're going to stick. This is week one. Right? There you go. And the rest are going to be in clean carbs. What I mean by clean is stay and try to make some of your own carbs. Don't go out and buy carbs. If you're going to eat pasta, eat some pasta at home. If you're going to eat some rice at home. Right? For now, for that first week, maybe 3 weeks, just make it yourself. Okay? So you can follow the rule. Right? Follow, you're going to learn and become aware. I'm going to get into this awareness thing in a minute because I'm going to break something down to you that's going to plug all of this in and turn you into probably a YouTube sensation. So you're going to take the clean carbs. You're going to go that first week, and let's assume you lost 1%. Let's say, oh, okay, I lost 3 pounds. Okay, you go in the second week, still there, still at 21.60. You go into that second week and it's going to slow down a little bit, right? You're like, oh, I then lost a pound, right? Or let's just say it's a pound. Might be more, could be, right? Stay there. Don't leave it. If it's still 1%, stay there. Don't leave. So you might be, let's say 1% of 180, you're probably at lost about 4 pounds. That's pretty good. That's almost what? That's 20% of four, right? It's about, 20% of the weight that you want to lose. So it's 4 pounds, a little less, but going to the third week. So now you're into your third week. This is an assumption. So what you're going to do, and you go third week, nothing. You might have lost a half a pound. Drop the calories down to 1080. So you're down 180 calories less. Keep the protein the same and don't lower it. Don't lower the fat. Keep it at 50 at minimum. Or you can go down to 40, but don't go any lower than that. Remember, protein and fats are essential. Carbs are not. So we're going to eliminate 180 calories of carbohydrates. Guess what? You're still going to be able to eat some fun ones, right? You're not eliminating anything within reason. I'm not talking about staying down, going down the snack aisle and building your carbs down there. Okay, so you're going to go another week. Guess what? Boom, you just lost, let's say, another 1%. Now you're down 7 pounds, seven pounds. Whoa, great. You're at a good marker, right? You're at about 34. I'm not using percentages because I'm stuck right now at it because I'm excited. So moving ahead here, you go into, this is your third week. So you go into your fourth week. And guess what? You may have lost, you're working out, you've lost some more weight. Let's assume that I'm just going to give you a breakdown to become aware. Let's assume that you're down 3 more pounds, which becomes more than 1%. You can move the calories up a little bit or stay the same. Move your protein closer to the 200 grams. Move your fat closer to the 60 grams. Keep your carbs down a little bit. We're using carbs for what you eat, and make sure you're not eating 3 hours before bed, at least maybe four, at least 3 hours before bed, okay? Now, let's assume you plateau after week 5. You're like, I didn't lose anything. You're gonna drop that bad boy down to 1,800 calories. Notice you're not going down to these extravagant numbers to 1,500, 1,600. You're just doing this over time so you can maintain muscle. Because if you want those abs to show or muscle to show, you don't want to lose muscle. You want to keep it by eating enough protein, getting enough fats in there, because fats metabolize a lot of things in our body. We need them. They are essential. Again, protein is essential. It's carbohydrates are not essential. You need them for energy. You don't need them to build life. You need them to build muscle at some point for insulin, but that's not too much science for the person who told me to tell people not to focus on calories. So moving ahead here, you can adjust these accordingly, and eventually you're going to get to a point when you're exercising, okay, and just take a really good snapshot of this and really follow it in a way that puts you in control of your calories in a way that you're able to progressively lose weight. And you can stay on this because you are still going to be eating food in these calorie ranges that you enjoy. You're not going on some kind of diet. You're going on a nutrition journey. Nutrition first, diets last. Don't worry about going on the keto diet. Don't worry about intermittent fasting. If you want to start do that, fine. Don't really focus on that part of it. I believe that intermittent fasting is great. If you can skip eating breakfast to like 11, 12 o'clock in the morning, or 12 o'clock noon, it'd be great. But the next phase of this, to plug all of this in that's here, get this food scale. And I'm not getting paid for this food scale. This is one of the best food scales that I've ever seen when it comes to, it's the E-Tech City Smart Nutrition Scale. There's an app for the phone, for your smartphone. You can weigh out anything. And I'm going to use a banana as an example. Because bananas don't come in exact sizes, right? They don't. It's like going to Chipotle and Chipotle telling you, oh, this is 1,000 calories as they're slopping everything in there. No, they're allowed to be off by 20 to 25% either way. Probably more on the other side. Think about that. If you go to Chipotle for a 1,000 calorie bowl, right? And it's really 1,250. Yeah, it's 250 extra calories. That blows that nonsense right up. Counting calories. But this will take a banana, and you like a big banana, normally, okay, it's 110, you know, they'll say it's about 110 calories. No, the small one's 110 calories. That big one's about 240. Big difference for numbers. You weigh that out, it will tell you that here, right? And I'm using that as one example, but there's two main examples that I want to use this for. One, it keeps track of everything. As a barometer, it's not exact, but you will be able to build this in the correct way by learning what food looks like, measurements of food, what 4 ounces of chicken looks like, what 4 ounces of tofu looks like, beef, pasta, and rice are two of the biggest unweighed items ever. No one goes into certain restaurants and says, wow, I'm gonna get a pasta dish and build it around my protein. No, walk in there and build protein around the pasta, right? Start with protein first, which can be very expensive, right? Can be. Again, take a week, take 2 weeks, take 3 weeks measuring your food out. But when you measure pasta, it's exact. When you measure rice, you can be close to exact and really see what a cup of rice, when you're done cooking a cup of rice, what that really looks like. Right? So when you're making it, you know what it looks like over time. You're not going to know right away, but you're going to be able to judge for yourself what servings are without being inundated with carrying this around all the time. There is nothing wrong with learning how this works for you when it comes to this. To me, what's wrong is we will buy the next iPhone or the next whatever phone or the next, and we will learn every single thing about it. Even though we bought one 6 months ago, a year ago, right? But we won't take our time to learn how to measure food for body fat loss, for body fat recomposition when it comes to losing that belly fat, right? And focusing in on that because it takes a little bit of time to really become aware, to learn how to focus on the caloric deficit that turns into the macros, and the macros are weighed in a way to help you maintain this loss of weight. And it becomes body fat. It becomes spot losing the weight. You will be able to narrow down losing by incorporating the next board that I would have here is different workouts. Resistance training will burn a boat ton of calories because you're going to build some muscle. More muscle, not a lot, doesn't burn a lot of calories, but over time it can, right? Over time, these numbers will work. Over time, you will be able to increase these numbers because your body becomes more efficient as you're working out, as you're doing those fun things like for instance, let's say you play basketball or tennis or whatever physical sport that you burn a lot of calories doing, you can move these calories up and enjoy more of those foods. There are some reputable, there's three people that I follow on here very closely that I absolutely adore, because if I, like I said, if I sat down with them right now, this would be some of the same stuff we would talk about. And when it comes to like losing that body fat and being able to eat more calories, for instance, I can eat 3,500 calories today because I know I'm gonna burn 4,000, right? Because I got a lot going on and I'm jacked today. I'm just using it as a number, but that's not my normal caloric intake. But I'm enjoying some other foods that I normally wouldn't eat because it's mostly fruit, right? And that I wouldn't normally eat because I need it. I need the energy. I need it because my caloric. I don't want to drop down 1,000-1,500 calories less per day for this specific day. But you will enjoy more food and be able to maintain these weights. Get down. If you want to get down to 170, get down to 170. If you want to get down to 160, you get down to 160 by adjusting these accordingly based on that number. I'm not saying forget the calculators. I'm not saying not go see a doctor, because you should, okay? But this, to me, is so not just so much healthier, but so much better that you can keep track of. And then when 90 days, 6 months, a year, over that time frame, you're not thinking about the scale all the time. You're not thinking about your food. You know what it looks like. You know, because when you lose that weight, you get that six-pack, that four-pack, or that two-pack, whatever pack you're getting, you maintain it and you build on it. That's all I got, guys and gals. But please let me know, comment below. Let me know how full of crap I am or not when it comes to just being aware and learning and really becoming and optimizing your nutrition in a way that is not life altering to the point where you're on a diet that doesn't work long term, and you know, and tracking calories and tracking that process. And really doing that in the beginning, do it for a while and you will learn. Like I love this one because it's the first one I got that actually is part of my phone. I really want to see this time around because I'm going to lose 5 pounds of body fat, but really see, I'm going to do a breakdown of what it's doing. I just didn't do it on here because this would be a 30 minute video because I'm not cutting nothing. But guys, gals, thank you. I'll talk to you soon. Later.